Hello and welcome to my first video log. I'm Tasha and I'm the creator of imallergictolife.blogspot.com. Today I'm going to talk about hair loss. This doesn't happen to everybody. Most people lose just a little bit, some people lose it all, but it really depends on the person and their individual condition. My hair started falling out towards the end of June. It started coming out in little bits, like when I'd shower I'd notice more would come out, but there wasn't any obvious patches. It wasn't until about 3-4 weeks later that I noticed I was starting to develop bald spots. Now, at this point in time, I was in and out of hospital a lot, so that wasn't my main concern. My hair loss started to become more noticeable. I found bald spots. They mainly started at the side, each side, and in the middle at the top. And there was a little bit at the bottom, just at the back, but I had really long blonde hair, so it was quite easy to just pin my hair back in a certain way that would easily cover it, and I figured it'd grow back pretty quickly. It was only when those bald spots started to get bigger that I realised that something was going on. I spoke to a few different people and I was referred to a dermatologist, but I turned down the appointment because at this time I was, like I said, I was in and out of hospital all the time, on top of like all different appointments for different things, and I just really didn't want to be spending any more time in hospital. And I figured that like losing my hair wasn't my biggest concern because you can live with no hair. After a while, it was starting to affect my day-to-day life. I'd go in the shower, I'd brush my hair, and it would come out not even in bits, like in full clumps of hair. And I was getting, by this stage, I was getting a bit upset. I had a massive reaction with the intensive care doctors looking after me. And then 2 days later, I was like, no, my hair has to go. Because when I came out of hospital after that, my hair was just so, like, it was just going. Like, you could tell it wasn't showing any signs of slowing down or changing or growing back at all. It was just coming out. When I'd go to hug people, as people would pull away, they'd like catch my hair a bit and like a whole chunk would come out. I'm talking like massive patches would just tear out. It was so brittle. It was just falling out. So while I still had long hair, I decided that someone should benefit from that because I was going to lose it. It wasn't going to be any use to me. So at least if I shaved it off, I could give it to charity, and I gave it to a charity called the Princess Trust, and they use your hair and make it into a wig for a child with cancer. I could have had it made into a wig for me. That thought didn't pop into my mind till after I donated the hair and someone mentioned it to me about 2 months later. So yeah, that didn't happen. Basically, I went to my hairdressers and said, can you shave my hair off? It was July 16th that my hair came off. So I shaved all my hair and you could see these like massive bald spots. I think the worst one was on the right side. It was just like a massive spot. And I decided that by shaving my hair off, I could let it grow through. Now for the first 2 months, my hair did not grow. And when it did grow, it grew back where I already had hair and the bald patches didn't grow. So I had to keep shaving my head in order to let the bald patches grow to the same level as the rest of my head, because that was the whole point of shaving it, so it would grow through at the same time. It was quite a big day because I'd realised that, hey, I'm bald now, people look at me funny, you know, and how can I adjust to this, you know? I had the option of wearing a wig, but I turned that down because they were itchy, they didn't suit my face. I've got quite a small head and all the wigs looked like they were eating me. So I didn't really want that look. I tried hats quite a lot, but they were really warm. So I went with like hair accessories. Mostly I went for headbands with flowers to cover the patch, the main patch, because that's what worked best for me and I felt comfortable with that. People still looked at me like I'd go out shopping with friends and there'd be people like... And like I could see people like nudging each other. And on a bad day, that would really hurt my feelings because, you know, why are you staring at me? This is not my fault. I didn't ask for this. Like, don't judge what you don't understand. But on a good day, I'd walk past with my head held high and I wouldn't care. You know, I could turn around and say to them, take a picture, it'll last longer. Because to be honest, It was my body, and if I didn't want any hair, if I'd chosen to shave off by choice, then, you know, what's that got to do with them? It's my hair, my problem, not theirs. So, my advice to anyone that's losing their hair now is try not to worry about it. I know it sounds really daft because your hair is a big part of you, as I realise. It's a big part of your personality, and how you dress coordinates around that. And I had no idea until I lost it. I found a lot of outfits I used to wear looked awful with no hair. I looked like a guy. I had to dress like a girl. I couldn't go out in jeans and a t-shirt because I got called sir. Yeah, I went to a shop and people would be like, excuse me, sir, and I'd turn around like... And sometimes they'd be like, oh, sorry, and other times they wouldn't even notice. So yeah, that was a bit weird. But most people were really understanding. My friends and family were really supportive. They helped me any way they could. They made me feel really good. My local newspaper actually wrote an article about it. So I was in The Guardian, and there was a story about me, and it's Tasha does a Jesse J to counter condition. So yeah, if you're losing your hair, don't panic. If your hair's gonna fall out for whatever reason, you stressing over it won't keep it in, as I found, because no matter how upset I got about it and how frustrated, it still came out. You know, there was nothing I could do about it, and I was just exhausting myself, fretting over it. And I would definitely say I'm a more confident person since I lost my hair. Like, I wouldn't have dreamed of doing something like this, like a video log, because I was afraid people would laugh at me. That many people laughed at me when I lost my hair at first that didn't understand. I really just don't care anymore. Okay, wigs. If you choose to wear a wig, there are several different choices. There are human hair wigs, they cost a lot. There are the fake acrylic-y ones that itch like mad and you can't brush them, and like, you brush them and then you just go whoosh. Yeah. Colours. I actually bought a wig online. Don't do that either. Unless you've seen it in the shop, tried it on and then bought it online. Don't do that. I bought this long wig and then I put it on and I was like Rapunzel, and it was golden, not blonde, kind of yellowy. And although it sat okay on my face, it was the best one that suited me. I didn't half look awful. So yeah, that was my story with wigs. If you choose a wig, make sure you're comfortable with it, you know how to care for it, you can style it the night before, and then when you go out the next day, all you have to do is literally put your hair on. My hair actually grew back very dark. Like, my hair was quite blonde, and when it grew back, it grew back. When it was short and stubbly, it was extremely dark. It's grown back a little bit lighter, but I've actually had highlights put in. It came back a lot thicker than my hair was originally. So it was thicker, it was darker. It was the same straightness. I'd always had very naturally straight hair. It came back the same, but I was prepared for anything. I could have come back with really, really dark hair, curly. I could have come back with ginger, brown hair, anything. You know, I was prepared. Now, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. There's two places that my hair has never grown back, and they are on either side of my head. Like, this bit has a little bit of baby hair, but that's about it, and they say that I don't think it's ever gonna grow back, and it's the same on this side. So when my hair grows longer, when I tie it back, you'll be able to see it. But for now, I can hide it pretty well, and you know, it's something I'm gonna live with now because it's not really showing any sign of growth. I mean, it grows this baby tufty hair, but it never stays around. And I'll put in some pictures of like a timeline of my hair. I didn't get any at first when my hair was non-existent because I was in, like I said, I was in out of hospital a lot. I have a few pictures in hospital, but the timeline isn't perfect because I missed out big chunks of time being ill. Sorry, a bit inconvenient, I know. So yeah, this concludes my first ever video log. Don't know how to end this. Bye. You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase into a weapon or a drug. You can be the outcast or be the backlash of somebody's lack of love. Speaking up, nothing's gonna hurt you the way the words do when they
you say